Hey, Luke Faccini here, and today I'm going to share with you my system for RPM using digital tools. Paper-based planning doesn't work for me. I carry my phone with me everywhere, and I use my laptop for planning the week. My goal is to share this methodology with you with the view that as a group, as a community, we can improve it. You can help me find a better way to do it so that I can be operationally the best that I can, and vice versa. So the tools that we are using are Asana, which is an awesome planning tool. I run a 12-person digital marketing branding agency, and it is perfect for me to assign tasks and project manage and do all of that stuff. And it's free for up to 15 users. So it's perfect for you to use for your planning. The second tool that we use is Google Calendar. That allows us to sync the calendar from Asana into a Google Calendar for daily planning. And I'll show you that in more detail shortly. You've created your Asana account and you've logged in. So you've got a view similar to this. This is my dashboard. What we're going to do is create a new project. I've got one in existence, which we'll look at later, my RPM planner, but you're going to create one from scratch. So you click on the plus sign and click project. Give it a name, RPM. Leave this stuff as default. Hit create project. Okay. So there's a few things you'll need to look at in here, you'll need to keep in mind. One is that you can create a category, which, get rid of cap lock, capture. I named this capture, put a colon, that there gives you a category. Then you can add your tasks in beneath. So my method here is an abbreviation for the client or personal, so P for personal, and then task description. I also think about how long it's going to take and put in the time there, which we'll use later when we map the time into our calendar. It's a good idea here to get into the result, the purpose, and the actions, the massive actions that you want to do in that, so that the description then carries through into the calendar as well. Now you can add another one simply by copying and pasting or adding a new line. So let's call this client do the thing 2 hours. Right. Now, if you had another category here, which we'll have a look at, so this could be a major project title or something that you've created as a project based off your RPM planning, you can then just click and drag these into that project. So you can drag these around. It's a really easy way to organize stuff, so when you get to the planning time, you'll have that there. So one of the things you want to look at also in this, with each project, you can assign them. So you can choose a staff member if you've got staff added, or assign it to yourself, and add a due date if you know the day that you want to do it on. So pick a day. You can add subtasks here. So if you're managing a project and the project has multiple different tasks in it, then you can just do the same thing with the tasks here. So go subtask. And then again, you can add more in, you can assign these and add dates for them. So that's essentially what you need to know here. You can add followers, people in your team, or you can assign it to people in their team. Or the other thing too is if you use this as a project management tool, which you have a look here, if I open up my menu, I've got a whole bunch of projects here. So what you can do is add these to a different project. So internally, sp- sponge internal projects. This could be in there as well, or you can just move it directly into that by deleting the other one out of it. So you can use this as a way to plan for bigger projects and smaller ones. So those are the essentials. Colon for category, the task title and time, assigning it and to yourself or somebody else in the deadline. And there's the calendar view, which you'll see that in a moment where it comes into effect. So I'm going to open up my RPM planner, which is populated. And you'll see here I have a whole bunch of tasks. And what I haven't done is categorize these into projects. That is something that it's a bit more time consuming and you can get into it, but I can show you what that looks like. So category, a project, the major results, so the R, and the purpose. So I could then drag any of those tasks into this project or this category, and they're there for me to do my planning, my prioritizing. So let's go back up and have a look at these. Now I have planned these because I do it on a Friday and I assign the days and look at the times of the things that I need to get done. I can use this calendar view to ensure that I am budgeting the right amount of time. So these ones here, while this is not the week that we're in, I don't do 10 hours a day of work, so they'll have to be manipulated to fit properly. So again, you can drag and drop things within the days here, which is kind of cool. You can double click them and you can edit them, add more detail, that kind of thing. So you get your core week planned in Asana. And the other beautiful thing here is that you can sync this calendar to your Google Calendar. So you do that by jumping in here, copying and pasting this link here, and then going into Google. So let's go into Google now. So you can see here, you can add a calendar by URL. Now I've done that, and that's the green one here, My Tasks. So you can see how they show up for this day sitting above the calendar. And that's really cool. That's where we're going to be doing the planning from. So I've got this one already in the calendar, the team meeting over here. The other ones I have to place. So click it, click on copy to my calendar, and then you click find a time and find a time. So this is the digital strategy. I'm going to do that at 2:30 for an hour. Save, done. You can add guests to it, whatever you need to do. Similarly, the social media, click it once, copy the calendar, I'll do that before my coaching meeting. Done. All right, so they're in the calendar and they're there now, they're scheduled. That's how you do your big blocks. And you'll be able to see the other items that were through the remainder of the week. You can look at it in week view if you like. You can see them all there, and then you can plan accordingly. You can click on the event and you'll see the details that come across from Asana. So the more detailed you are, the less you have to actually have to go back to Asana to get the details. So that's pretty much it. Do your planning in Asana on a Friday or a Sunday, depending on which one that you work with. And you have to keep in mind that Google Calendar syncs about once every 24 hours. It's not an instantaneous thing at the moment. Hopefully they'll change that. So these will show up tomorrow if you make changes. So do your plan. It's a good idea to do your planning a day before you're going to plan your day. Right now I'm screen sharing my iPhone, so you can see how easy it is to capture in Asana and why I've chose that. So let's launch Asana now, and you can see here, this is the task view. I can click on projects, my RPM planner, and now I can just start adding tasks. So let's say Client, do that. Brand planning. Hit enter and it's there. Or if it's personal, buy wife a bunch of flowers. Or personal, test drive Tesla. I already did that, but anyway, you see where I'm going. It's pretty easy just to add in tasks here, and you can do it on the fly, and then you can drag them around if you need be. So if you want to do your planning, you can put that into a category, easy enough. You can assign it to yourself, put a due date, easy. You can add subtasks here. You can do whatever you want. So there's a lot of good stuff in this. You can assign it to somebody else. You can do pretty much your planning in this. I like to capture everything here and do the actual physical week planning on my laptop. It's much easier. So the other thing I showed on the desktop was how this appears in the daily calendar. So you will also get, see, we've got here the yellow is the linked, the synced calendar. So it shows up just as simply as it does on the desktop, and you can drill in and see, like click on the link and it'll launch Asana. So that's the mobile, and that's why I love this. So let me know how you go.